had to change what I wear on my feet because in the middle of the night I woke up with such excruciating cramps in both legs. So I got up and I tried to walk, and you know, it got a little better after a few minutes, so I had to walk around a while. And then of course I couldn't sleep, so I started listening to videos on YouTube about the leg cramps and looking up things online. So what I think I've learned is that when I'm standing for hours in the kitchen, you know, cooking and making salads and baking and all that, that it's not enough for me to just, you know, move around my legs and, you know, stretch my feet and ankles. It's not enough. I have to wear a shoe that, you know, that's, you know, soft, like some kind of hard foam. And the only thing I could think of that's the best is, you know, flip-flops. And in order to wear the flip-flops, you have to have a very, very loose sock, you know, to go there. And then leg warmers help, because you have to keep the muscles in the lower leg warm. And as you get older, you have a tendency to get more leg cramps. So I don't know, I eat very healthy, I exercise, but it seems that standing on a hard floor can, you know, after many hours, it can lead to these terrible pains. So I'm going to try with the flip-flops and the loose socks and the leg warmers and see what happens. And I'm thinking that whatever happens to us, no matter how unpleasant, we can use it somehow for good. Now, my dog, when he was given to me at age five years, he already had many, many dental problems. So, you know, I brush his teeth sometimes, and once, a few years ago, I took him to the dentist, the veterinarian, and they gave him anesthesia, made him unconscious, they did a thorough cleaning under the gums, they removed some rotten teeth, some teeth just fell out. And, you know, besides the anesthesia, and when he was waiting in the surgical area, you know, they had him in a cage, he was howling the whole time, this is what they told me. And then when I brought him home, you have to give them painkillers. And I don't think he can handle all that right now. At, you know, on February 14th, Valentine's Day, is going to be 15 years old. Otherwise, he's doing great, you know, lots of energy, eats well, happy. So I decided that homemade dog biscuit, which turned into a vegan jerky, that I like eating, that I'm going to try giving it to him. So I did that this morning, and I'm thinking that because it's so chewy and he has to really work on it with his teeth, that it'll be like one of those tooth cleaning dog biscuits that they sell. So he ate it okay, and he loved it. So I made another batch now, and we'll see what happens. So I think, again, everything that happens to us, we can use it for good. We can learn things from it. Maybe someone else we can help, that someone who has the same problem. And that's about it. Keep trying. I keep trying with this laptop. It's not a laptop. This tablet. The neighbor who gave it to me across the street, she told me today she couldn't handle it because it's so slow. Anyway, I'm very slow, so maybe I can handle it.